left here feeling pretty angry. Oh, no, I wasn't angry at you. I was angry at myself because I realized you were right. Instead of a refuge, I've been using this house as a hiding place. As I was driving around, I realized there was someone else I was even more angry at.
Who?
Cindy. The more I thought about what she did to me, the angrier I got. So I drove over to her place and gave her a piece of my mind.
Really?
Yeah. I told her I was furious at her for lying to me, but I wasn't going to be a victim anymore. And that she was stupid to let a great guy like me get away.
Great. All right.
Good for you. That must have felt great.
Oh, no, it was awful. But once I'd done it, I finally felt like I could move on. So I stopped by that apartment on Regal Place and put down a deposit on it.
Oh, congratulations, Dan.
Well, I couldn't have done it without all your help. Especially yours, Sandy. Thanks. You're a good friend.
Me too.
Well, excuse me, I got some packing to do.
Need some help?
Sure.
Well, gotta hand it to you. You came out of the snow like a rose. You really helped Stan.
Thank you, David.
And you taught me a big lesson.
What lesson's that?
That, if you take enough shots in the dark,
uh-huh.
One of them's bound to hit the target.
David.
I was just kidding. Over
5 minutes, we'll be joining Linda Mitchell and Karen Keating for summer singing at the National Garden Festival. That's after the news now with Chris Lowe. Labour and the Liberal Democrats have condemned the profits announced today in the electricity industry. The distribution company Norweb has almost doubled its profits, while the generating company National Power's profits went up by 18%. And National Power confirmed plans to cut 2,400 jobs.
When National Power was created 2 years ago, it employed 17,000 people. The job cuts planned for this financial year will take its staff down to little more than half that. At the same time, it announced its profits for the year to March rose to £514 million. This morning, the company defended its performance.
I think the privatisation of the electricity industry is going extremely well. It is putting a hard downward pressure on costs, and customers will benefit.
Meanwhile, there were further protests over the near doubling of profits by the power distributor Norweb, and both results are set to fuel the row over the profits being made by the privatised power industry.
Forensic experts are examining the wreckage of a minicab which was hijacked and then blown up in central London last night. Police believe the attack was the work of the IRA. No one was hurt.
The minicab was wrecked by around 2 pounds of high explosives. The owner was ordered at gunpoint to drive around the West End. His two passengers then told him to stop in St Albans Street near Piccadilly Circus. They ran off, telling him he had 15 minutes to get out. If, as police assume, this bombing was the work of the IRA, it will be the third terrorist attack in London in 9 days, all of them involving small bombs planted late at night or in the early hours of the morning. Police will also be concerned that a tactic often used in Northern Ireland has been exported to the British mainland for the first time.
The release of the last Western hostages in Lebanon is now said to be imminent. Earlier, the Syrian news agency